The reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. While Jesus was still speaking to the crowds, his mother and his brothers were standing outside, wanting to speak to him. Someone told him, "Look, your mother and your brothers are standing outside, wanting to speak to you." But to the one who had told him this, Jesus replied, "Who is my mother? And who are my brothers?" And pointing to his disciples, he said, "Here are my mother and my brothers. For whoever does the will of my Father in heaven is my brother and sister and mother." The Gospel of the Lord. Here are my mother and my brothers. Dear my brothers and sisters, could you imagine that when Jesus pointed to his disciples and said these words, you were among that group of people who were listening to his word carefully? I can feel how happy these people were when Jesus accepted them into God's family and regarded them as his brothers and sisters. Do you know what it counted for membership in Jesus' family? Is it blood tie, or race, or social class, or even greed? Fortunately, Jesus would regard none of these conditions. For him, listening to his words and doing God's will are the most important criteria. Many people have criticized Jesus because, based on this test, it seemed like he did deny his family tie and disrespected his mother and brothers. In contrast, Jesus not only regarded his mother as the first one who listened to God's words and fulfilled it, but also extended his family to all listeners. During these days, while many do not want to go back to church, you are so faithful to come here to listen to the words of God. All of you do make the first important step to be numbered in God's family. The second step is that we need to carry this word out to practicing them in our lives, to love God and our neighbors. Last December, I went to Houston for the FSBN conference. I was so impressed by the hospitality of the Vietnamese family, who volunteered to pick me and other sisters up from the airport and welcome us into their home as we were noble guests. After all, we still keep in touch with each other. One day, Mrs. Hong called and asked me to pray for her neighbor's family who were affected by coronavirus. I asked her about how these families could be fed when both of them were sick and her children were little. Mrs. Hong said, every day before she went to work, she cooked for both her and her neighbor's family. Then her husband brought food and all the necessary things and placed them in their neighbor's front door. It took 1 month for this couple to combat coronavirus. It also means Mrs. Hong and her family aided for the needs of the neighbors 1 month. My dear friends, can you bring God's love and compassion to others, especially to the poor, the marginalized, and the vulnerable like Mrs. Hong and her family did? When you love God, you will find the proper way that would please Him. you will find a way to love him with all your heart, soul, and mind. And you also find the best way to love and serve your kids, your spouse, your parents, and others. Let's be joyful and grateful for being Jesus' brothers and sisters, and do whatever your heart tells you.